In this video I will make 4 wooden clamps. These are not the best clamps, but I have used them a lot. I can use a piece of board with a small strip screwed to it to cut the 4 bases to the same length. I measure the depth L of the tenons that I make with my tenon router jig, and I cut 2 pieces with a length equal to 2 times L plus 140 mm. I make a mark in the middle to cut it later in 2 equal parts. I will call it piece 1. I can make a stop using a clamp and a piece of wood. That way I only need to measure once. I cut the 4 pieces to make the handles. And I cut 10 pieces 5 cm long, too. Before I grab the pieces I have just cut, I like to wait for the saw blade to stop spinning. Using my tenon router jig, I make a tenon in each end of piece 1. I cut the pieces in 2 equal pieces. That way I obtain 4 piece 1, one for each of the 4 clamps I am making. With my mortise router jig I make a mortise in the end of the base, to join the base and the piece 1. I cut the thread rod to the wish length. When I cut the thread rod, I deform the threads. I put a nut to each side of the place where I will cut. That way I can reshape the threads after the cut is made. With a 8 mm drill bit I make a hole all along the handles, from one end to the other. I tighten 2 nuts, one against the other, to screw easily the thread rod in the handle using a wrench. I draw the outline of the shape I want to give to our handles, and using a small plane I shape them. Using a well-sharpened chisel, I make a chamfer in the ends of the handles, and then I make it round with some sanding. With the 8 mm drill bit, I drill a hole from side to side in two of the 5 cm pieces I had cut before, and I split them in two. I will call piece 2 to each side. I will call piece 3 to the other 5 cm pieces I have. If the surface of the piece 2 I have just cut doesn't look very nice, I can flatten it with a chisel. With a 20 mm Forstner drill bit, I make a blind hole in 4 of the pieces 3. The hole must be big enough to put inside a washer and a nut. I prepare some cold welding, and I pour it inside the hole of the handles. Using the drill at low speed, it is very easy to screw the rods inside the handles. I let the rod protrude about 2 cm, and I put a washer and a nut. In the other side, I only put a nut, so it squashes the wood when I tighten both nuts. With a 10 mm drill bit, I make a hole in the piece 1, from side to side. I didn't have a 10 mm wood drill bit, so I use one 8 mm wood drill bit, and I finish the hole with a 10 mm metal drill bit. That was a bad idea, because the final holes were not fine. It would be better to wait until I get a 10 mm wood drill bit. I put a T-nut inside each side of the hole. These ones are designed to screw using an Allen wrench, and they are very easy to insert in the hole. I screw the rod inside both T-nuts. If it is hard to screw, I can use some oil. If it is very hard to screw, then I can remove the T-nut near the handle, and I can let in place only the T-nut in the side of the base. I put the piece 2 in the rod. I pour some cold welding in the tip of the rod, and I put a nut. I put a washer inside the hole I made in the piece 3. I pour some wood glue, and I glue piece 2 and piece 3 together. I draw the middle line in the face of the base where I made the mortise. I mark the positions for the holes I need to insert the dowels, and with a 10 mm bit and a depth stop, I drill the holes. I drill a hole in the pieces 3, and I glue a dowel. If the tenons are too tight inside the mortises, I can adjust them with a chisel. I pour some glue in the tenon and in the mortise, and I join piece 1 and the base together. I clamp them until the glue dries. And there I have my wooden clamps. The truth is, I am not really happy with the end result, because I have to use metallic clamps to keep the small blocks with the dowel in place. but because I don't have fancy clamps, so far I have used these wooden clamps a lot. Thanks for watching. You can find all my woodworking videos in my YouTube channel. And if you like my videos, remember that you can subscribe to my channel.